Today, we're making this. All right, we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's go back to the beginning. Man, I love Breakout games. Or more accurately, I love Arkanoid, which is obviously the best Breakout game ever made. In the meantime, the genre has been left to wither and die off. So today's design challenge is to revive the genre, and to give it something it hasn't had for years.
Innovation.
Innovation. Let's get started then. New project in Unity, throw up a few walls and a bat as a test. We're using Unity's physics engine to give us a head. Wait a sec. Head start. Okay, let's add some player control to the bat. Nice. Okay, time to
innovate.
Let's add some. Maybe some. How about crafting? What genre hasn't crafting improved? Nope, these are mindless C-suite exec level ideas. We don't just want to skin the game and dress it up as something it's not. What we want is to innovate the core mechanic. What we want is this. And this. And definitely a bit of this. Yep, we're going to add spin to the genre. It should feel pretty natural. You just whip the bat sideways as you make contact with the ball to add spin. So let's do a quick pass. Yep, there's definitely something there, so I think I need to add some bricks in order to test it out properly. Yep, seems to work well. I wonder what would happen if we add a special meter that fills up when you clear bricks. And then when you activate the special, it just rips through the bricks like they're not even there. Yeah, there's definitely something there, but it doesn't feel quite right. I need to add a scoring system to help me judge the new mechanics. And maybe for fun we make it so that as you hit consecutive bricks without dying or hitting the bat, the score for each brick goes up. Alright, we've got some stuff up and running. Let's take a quick design inventory. Spin. Feels good. Definitely something there. Scoring rewards for long runs. Also good. Reward strategic play and high skill. Special meter. Okay, you know what's been nagging at me? Meters are lazy design. They often represent a lack of imagination on the part of the... Anyway, yeah, let's spin the meter. It's an unnecessary complication and takes away from the core of the game, which is going to be spin. So let's double down on that, remove the meter, and just make it so that spin breaks through the bricks by itself. That's pretty powerful. Maybe too powerful? But it's compelling enough that I'm going to let it ride and see how the game balances once I add more stuff. Let's add some more boring stuff like lives and a game over screen. What we really need now is levels. I want each level to throw some new mechanic into the mix to make things way more difficult. Let's get to work. How about some moving bricks to start off with? Pretty easy. What if we up the difficulty a bit by adding screen wrap, so then if the ball goes off the right-hand side of the screen, it comes back on the left and vice versa? This can get you turned around pretty quickly. Time to ramp up the difficulty a bit. Let's add a second bat, but make the second bat move in the opposite way to the first. What about if the second bat is at the top of the screen so you're essentially playing Pong against yourself? Honestly, it's really easy to find novel stuff to do with this game since the genre has been so neglected over the years. And finally, let's add a boss level, but I'll leave that as a surprise for anyone who plays the game. It's free, by the way, so look out for details coming up later in a video on how to play it. Alright, I'm pretty happy with how this plays now, but it looks terrible. Let's fix it. What could go wrong? First off, how about a gradient? Every graphic designer worth their salt will tell you you need to put gradients everywhere. Next, I found this neat Unity asset that lets you edit the perspective of the camera to do stuff like this. And as this perspective I learned is called Oblique Gentleman, and that sounds much too rude not to use. I could have just drawn a bricks like this, of course, but this will make more sense when I make the 3D stuff look fancier. Oh, and I added a life pickup, which can lead to some fun panic moments when the ball and life are dropping at the same time. Okay, next up we need to up our feedback game and make it feel really satisfying. Let's add some particles for breaking bricks. More particles for when the ball has enough spin to break through. Let's make the bat look like it's made of some sort of energy, give it a bit of glow. We really want to sell that moment when the spinning ball rips through the bricks. Let's add some screen shake and make time slow down a little when a brick is destroyed in this way. Alright, next up, let's model some proper bricks. I want them to be evocative of Lego without being too evocative, if you know what I mean. Good feedback really needs good sound, so let's work on that next.
Psych!
Yeah, the spin ball ripping through bricks really feels powerful now that we have particles, screen shake, sound, and a little timescale animation. And we're basically there. Time to add a pause screen and make the game over banner less ugly. Final task, a title screen. I threw together this simple, futuristic 70s look, which in retrospect I kinda wish I'd used for the whole game, but there you go. Now we need some music. This is just a small project, so I just wanna make a jingle rather than a full track. Yep, that'll do. And that's it, we're done. We can all go home. Good job, everyone. Time to... Ah, yes, the elephant in the room. So, there's this one thing that always bugs me about breakout games, and this one is no exception. When you get down to that last brick, it can take forever to hit. It feels really frustrating and slows the pace of the whole game down. What if, when we get to the last brick, we start a timer, and then if the player hasn't cleared the level before the timer goes off, we just destroy it anyway? Wait, there's an opportunity here. What if the timer is a bonus score which ticks down, and if you hit the brick before it expires, you get that bonus? And if you don't, then well, then you
get nothing! You lose! Good day, sir!
Yeah, that kicks butt. Well done, me. Alright, that really is it. Pretty happy with this one. In fact, if I was IGN, I would give it an 8.5 out of 10, 3 thumbs up and a gold star. And now, as promised, let's throw the whole thing up on itch.io and make it free. But that's no fun, so let's make scanning the QR code to download it into another game. Or you can just hit up the link in the description, you should probably just do that. Alright, that just about wraps up the whole episode. Don't forget to... like and subscribe. Bye!